जीएम और ईएमडी और एचएचपी इंट्रोडक्शन एंड जर्नल अरेंजमेंट। जीएम लोकोमोटिव ऑन इंडियन रेलवे हिस्ट्री। इन द अर्ली 1960 इंडियन रेलवे बिगेन कन्वर्शन ऑफ इट्स मेन लाइन फ्रॉम स्टीम ट्रैक्शन टू डीजल ट्रैक्शन। दैट टाइम इट वॉज ऑल्सो इन माइंड टू शट अप ए प्रोडक्शन यूनिट एंड स्टार्ट मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ डीजल लोकोमोटिव। सो टीओटी एग्रीमेंट वॉज मेड विथ अल्को फॉर प्रोडक्शन ऑफ डब्ल्यूडीएम टू डिजाइन लोकोमोटिव इन इंडियन रेलवे। एट द सेम टाइम इन 1962 72 लोकोमोटिव ऑफ जीएम डिजाइन दैट इज WDM4 ऑफ 2600 एचपी वेयर परचेज एंड इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इन इंडियन रेलवेज इन पैरेलल टू अल्को लोकोमोटिव। बट आफ्टर 36 ईयर अराउंड 1998 ऑल WDM4 लोकोमोटिव्स आर विथड्रॉन फ्रॉम इंडियन रेलवे ट्रैक्स। Need of HHP locomotive. To fulfill the following requirement, the GM locomotives of high horsepowers were introduced in Indian Railways. First, Railway Board has taken decision to increase carrying capacity of freight train from 4,700 tons to 5,294 tons and above. Second, on the existing routes, freight stroke is being upgraded to the speed of 100 km per hour. Third, it is also planned to increase the axle load up to 25 or 30 ton on the proposed freight corridor so that 120 wagon trains on freight corridors with trailing load of 14,400 tons can be hauled. Fourth, it is planned to upgrade speed of the passenger train to 150 km per hour on existing tracks and 200 km per hour on proposed passenger corridors. GM or HHP, TOP and manufacturing. In view of need of HHP locomotive, Indian Railway had entered into a TOP contract with Messrs. EMD USA in 1995 for manufacture of WDG4 locomotive. In 1999, under TOT, 21 numbers WDG4 locomotive supplied by GM to Indian Railways. DLW manufactured first GM design WDG4 locomotives in year 2001. These day around 2500 number of GM design locomotives are manufactured at DLW of 4500 horsepower, and these all locomotives are called as HHP locomotive or high horsepower locomotive. Normally, the performance of any diesel locomotives are measured on the following technical scales, and the design of HHP locomotives was coming up to mark on this scale, so agreements were made for TOT. These are fuel consumption. Second is starting tractive effort. Third is balancing speed. Fourth, starting capability. Fifth, blended brake. And another is improved safety. So now we'll discuss one by one on this technical feature. Fuel consumption in case of GM locomotive was very less in compared to the existing WDM2 locomotives, or it may be say that the fuel efficiency of GM locomotive was around 11% better than that of existing WDM2 locomotives. So this factor means fuel consumption factor was an important factor for purchasing the technology of GM. A starting tractive effort. In case of diesel locomotive, tractive effort is the force applied by the wheel on the rail track to haul the load. The tractive effort will be maximum at a start of locomotive and gradually decreases as speed of locomotive increases. If tractive effort is higher at a start, the accelerations of locomotive will be rapid. The tractive effort of WDG4 locomotive is very high, that is 53 ton, which is favorable indications in case of hauling heavy load. Balancing speed. Balancing speed of locomotive is that maximum speed on which locomotive may run continuously and comfortably for a long period without any abnormalities in engine. At balancing speed, tractive effort and train resistance balances. A good locomotive should have high balancing speed. In GM locomotive, the balancing speed is also very high. So this is very good for GM. From this slide, it clears that a balancing speed of WDP4 locomotive is 123 kilometers per hour when the locomotive is hauling the load of 18 ICF coaches and 6 AC coaches on level track. Similarly, WDG4 locomotives has 81 km per hour balancing speed on level track when it is hauling 58 box and wagon. This balancing speed for WDG4 locomotive and P4 locomotive is very good. From these slides, it clears that a starting hauling capability of WDG4 locomotive is very high compared to the other locomotives. Blended brake. In conventional locomotive, the dynamic brake and air brake are applied separately. But in GM design locomotive, the dynamic brakes and air brakes can be applied simultaneously till a stoppage of train. This brake feature in locomotive is called blended brake and controlled by computer system. Improved safety. Vigilance control device is an inbuilt safety device fitted in GM design locomotive. It alerts the driver by flashing light and ringing the alarm. GM loco and types. In 1999, Indian Railways introduced its first diesel electric locomotive with three-phase AC traction technology, that is WDG4 and WDP4. This technology taken from General Motors USA under TOT. WDG4 is suitable for goods operation while WDP4 is suitable for passenger operation. Further, freight loco, that is WDG4, is operated to WDG4D of 4500 HP. Similarly, passenger loco WDP4 is also operated to WDP4D of 4500 HP. WDP4D and WDG4D. In this slide, what are the differences between WDG4 and WDP4? That will be covered. Both locomotives are of GM design and both having the same horsepower, that is 4000 HP. WDP4 locomotive is suitable for the passenger operations, while WG4 is suitable for the freight operation. WDP4 locomotives can run with 160 km per hour. It is the operating speed. And WDG4 can run suitably with 100 km per hour. The axle load in case of WDP4 is 19.5 ton, while axle load of WDG4 is 21 ton. Tractive effort of WDP4 locomotive is 27.5 ton, while the tractive effort of WDG4 is 53 ton, which is very high. The bogie configurations of WDP4 is BO1-1BO. Means in WDP4 there are 4 traction motor total. WDG4 having coco bogie configuration. The gear ratio of WDP4 is 77:17, while in case of WDG4 the gear ratio is 90:17. Various HHP locomotives are compared here in this slides on the basis of different parameters like horsepower, tractive effort, bogie arrangement, operating speed, gear ratio and other data. WDG5 locomotive. Indian Railway was actively looking for higher horsepower loco to address the growing need for hauling heavier trains. With this intention, WDG5 loco of 5500 horsepower has been developed jointly by EMD and Indian Railways under a TOT contract. The main engine of this locomotive having 20 cylinders and each cylinder having 710 cubic inch displacement volume. The main engine of this loco is equipped with electronics unit injector and high efficient turbo supercharger. The bogie of WDG5 loco is high strength, low weight, also called as hybrid bogie or HTCF bogie. WDG5 loco is also called as Bheem. Till date, 7 locomotives of this design are manufactured by DLW and each locos are maintained at Sabarmati diesel shed. Layout of GM of or HHP locomotive. Various compartment of HHP locomotives can be easily understand in this layout. It is the front view of HHP locomotives which can be seen clearly in this slide. A GM or HHP locomotive consists of following compartments. First, nose compartment. Second, driver cabin. Third, ECC or electrical control cabinet. Fourth, traction control converter कंपार्टमेंट, फिफ्थ ट्रैक्शन जनरेटर कंपार्टमेंट, सिक्स इंजन कंपार्टमेंट, सेवन इंजन एसेसरीज कंपार्टमेंट, एट एयर कंप्रेशर कंपार्टमेंट, नाइन रेडिएटर कंपार्टमेंट एंड लास्ट इज सुपर स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ लोकोमोटिव. सो लेट अस डिस्कस वन बाय वन अबाउट दिस कंपार्टमेंट इन नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. नोज कंपार्टमेंट. नोज कंपार्टमेंट इज अटैच्ड टू ड्राइवर केबिन एट शॉर्ट हुड एंड ऑफ लोकोमोटिव. इन दिस कंपार्टमेंट ऑल न्यूमेटिक वाल्व्स रिलेटेड टू कंप्यूटर कंट्रोल ब्रेक सिस्टम ऑफ लोकोमोटिव्स आर फिटेड. वन डिस्प्ले यूनिट इज ऑल्सो लोकेटेड इन दिस कंपार्टमेंट. मैग्नेटिक वाल्व्स रिलेटेड टू सैंडिंग अरेंजमेंट और सैंडिंग सिस्टम्स आर ऑल्सो लोकेटेड इन दिस नोज कंपार्टमेंट. ड्राइवर केबिन ऑफ एचएचपी लोकोमोटिव. ड्राइवर केबिन इन एचएचपी लोकोमोटिव इज लोकेटेड एट शॉर्ट हुड एंड नेक्स्ट टू नोज कंपार्टमेंट. दिस ड्राइवर केबिन इज कॉल्ड एज केबिन नंबर वन. सम वेरिएंट्स ऑफ एचएचपी लोकोमोटिव लाइक WDG4D एंड WDP4D आर हैविंग टू ड्राइवर केबिन. ईच ड्राइवर केबिन हैज टू कंट्रोल स्टैंड और ए सिंगल यूनिट ऑफ कंट्रोल स्टैंड एज सून इन स्लाइड. दिस कंट्रोल स्टैंड कंसिस्ट ऑफ वेरियस गेजेस, रिवर्सल हैंडल, थ्रोटल हैंडल, ऑटोमेटिक ब्रेक वाल्व एंड VCD बटन ETC. इलेक्ट्रिकल कंट्रोल कैबिनेट. इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज ECC कंपार्टमेंट. There are four ECC compartment in dual cab GM locomotive and all cabinets are pressurized cabinets. ECC 1 is situated on the back wall of locomotive driver cabin. It controls and powers the locomotive and it consists of engine control panel, EM2000 display unit, सर्किट ब्रेकर पैनल, सर्किट ब्रेकर्स एंड टेस्ट पैनल. ECC 2 इज लोकेटेड इन द अंडर फ्रेम ऑफ द लोकोमोटिव बिटवीन ट्रक 1 एंड फ्यूल टैंक. इट हाउसेस बैटरी चार्जिंग असेंबली, ऑक्सिलरी जनरेटर सर्किट ब्रेकर्स, टर्मिनल बोर्ड फॉर connecting ECC 2 components to external system and last is DC linked reactor core. ECC 3 is located near the equipment rack at right side of locomotive. It is also called as EC cabinet. It contains radiator fan contactor, radiator fan fuses or circuit breakers. It is pressurized cabinet. ECC 4 may be seen in those locomotives in which there are dual cab. ECC 4 is located in cab number 2 of WDP4D or WDG4D loco. It contains circuit breaker panel, engine control panel, ground relay, cutout switches. TCC compartment is located next to ECC compartment in the locomotive. It consists of two TCC, electronics blowers, 8 dynamic brake grids, 4 numbers on each sides, 2 numbers dynamic grid cooling fans and 1 dustbin blower. The main function of TCC is to change DC power into variable AC power. TCC1 and TCC2 invert the DC link voltage into variable voltage, variable frequency, 3-phase AC power for the induction traction motor. Generator compartment. Generator compartment in GM loco or HHP locomotives is located between TCC compartment and engine compartment. This generator compartment houses two alternators. One alternator is called as a main alternator, and another is called as a companion alternator. In this compartment, there is one traction motor blower also. Turbo supercharger with after cooler can be seen in this compartment. There is one auxiliary generator also. One engine starting motor can be seen in this compartment also. There are two cyclonic filter which is vertically mounted on both side of the locomotive in this compartment. Traction alternator or main alternator of HHP locomotive. Traction alternator or main alternator converts mechanical power developed by the diesel engine into electrical power. The main alternator is a 3-phase alternator and it houses two rectifier banks for converting AC into DC. These are permanently connected in series. The field of main alternator is provided by companion alternator. Other details may be read in this slide. Companion alternator of HHP locomotive. Companion alternator is physically coupled but electrically independent to the main alternator. It supplies current to excite the main alternator field and to power the radiator cooling fan, dustbin blower motor, TCC electronics blower motor and various control devices. Other technical details may be read in this slide. Auxiliary generator of HHP locomotive. The auxiliary generator is driven by the engine gear train at 3 times the engine speed. AC power from the auxiliary generator is supplied to an external 3-phase full wave rectifier in a battery charging assembly. It is then converted to 74 volt DC power for companion alternator excitation, control system operation and charging locomotive batteries. The auxiliary generator also supplies 74 volt DC power for the fuel and turbocharger lube oil pump motor circuits, cab fans, locomotive's lighting and other miscellaneous equipments. Engine starting motor of HHP locomotive. The starting motor is located in alternator compartment at rear right side of diesel engine in HHP locomotive. It is having two solenoid called pickup and holding solenoids. These motors are 64 volt DC series motors which are connected in parallel for cranking of the diesel engine. Turbo supercharger of HHP locomotive. In HHP locomotive, turbo supercharger is mounted on rear end of the diesel engine and it is primarily used to increase engine horsepower and provide better fuel economy. HHP turbo supercharger is actually driven through the gear train and assisted by exhaust gas energy. HHP turbo supercharger is also known as dual behavior turbo supercharger. When the engine approaches full load, the heat energy in exhaust gases is sufficient to drive the turbo supercharger without any help from the engine. At this point, an overrunning clutch in the drive gear disengages and turbocharger drive is mechanically disconnected from the engine gear train. turbo screen is a protective device which protects the turbine blades from damage, and it is fitted in exhaust manifold. Engine compartment of HHP locomotive. Engine compartment of HHP locomotive is located between alternator compartment and accessories compartment. In this compartment, main engine can be seen as shown in slide. Other components involved in main engine can be understand in another slide. In HHP loco, diesel engine is V-type, 2-stroke, 16 cylinders, positive scavenging air system, high compression pressure. Engine arrangement of HHP locomotive. Diesel engine nomenclature like front end, rear end, left side, right side, etc. may be easily understand in this slide. Engine block or crankcase assembly of HHP locomotive. In HHP locomotive, the main structure component of the engine is the crankcase or engine block as shown in this slide. The engine block supports the power assemblies and cranks up and serves as a mounting for accessories such as lube oil pumps, turbocharger, etc. This engine is called as dry block design because the engine coolant circulates through water pocket built into the individual cylinder liner. Power pack or power assembly of HHP locomotive. Power pack or power assembly of HHP locomotive consists of cylinder liner, cylinder head, piston and rings, piston carrier assembly and connecting rod assembly. Depending on locomotive maintenance practices, the power assembly can be removed from the engine piece by piece or as a complete unit. In Indian Railways, power assembly is overhauled after every 3 years. Piston of HHP locomotive. HHP piston assembly consists of 4 compressor rings and 2 oil control rings. The piston may rotate or flop on piston carrier during engine operation. That's why it is also called as floating type piston. Due to this quality of piston, uniform clearance is being maintained between liner and piston. Connecting rod in HHP engine. In HHP, diesel engine uses an interlocking connecting rod design to connect the power assembly to the crankshaft. The connecting rod consists of fork rods, blades rods, basket hubs and a set of connecting rod lower bearings with the piston pin bolted directly to the connecting rod. Fork rods are installed on the left bank of engine while blade rods are installed on right bank of the engine. These are not interchangeable. Rocker arm assembly and valve grease. The rocker arm assembly acts as a operating mechanism for exhaust valve and fuel injector and is held in place by 2 stud on the top of the cylinder head. There are 3 rocker arms per cylinders, 2 exhaust and 1 injector. Unit injector or mechanical unit injector. Unit injector is a combination of pump and nozzle assembly. HHP diesel locomotive having 16 unit injector. Each cylinder head carries a unit injector which is actuated by a rocker arm from the camshaft. The Woodward governor controls injector to maintain the proper amount of fuel needed to keep the engine speed at the requested level. Ejector tube. Ejector is a mechanical device mounted on HHP engine at rear end near turbo supercharger. It functions on Venturi principle and creates required vacuum in crankcase by creating suction. To increase crankcase suction, large diameter nozzle may be applied. Engine accessories compartment of HHP locomotive. Engine accessories compartment of HHP locomotive is located in between engine compartment and compressor compartment. It houses one Woodward governor, three lubricating oil pump, two centrifugal water pump, one lubile cooler, one pressurized water tank or expansion tank, one fuel primary filter, one lube oil tank, one EPD and others. Water expansion tank of HHP locomotive. Expansion tank is mounted on equipment rack in accessories compartment of HHP locomotive. The capacity of this tank is 371 liters. The other details of expansion tank may be read in this slide. EPD or engine protection devices in HHP locomotive. Engine protection device in HHP locomotives are designed to shut down the engine in the event of malfunctioning occurring during engine operation. These devices are low oil pressure shutdown plunger. It is connected to governor. Second is low water and crankcase pressure detector assembly. It is also somehow connected to governor. Third is mechanical overspeed trip. It is connected to the rocker arm and fuel injector. Fourth, hot oil temperature. It is a separate device. It is also called as thermostatic valve. Fifth, low fuel oil pressure knock down. Compressor compartment of GM or HHP locomotive. In compressor compartment, one air compressor of two stage, three cylinder, water cooled may be seen. This air compressor is rotated at engine speed and supplies the necessary air pressure for brakes and other pneumatic devices such as sander, windshield, wipers, shutter operating cylinder, the horn and the bell. Other details may be seen in this slide. Radiator compartment of HHP locomotive. Radiator compartment is located at long hood end of HHP locomotive. This compartment mainly houses two roof-mounted radiator core, two AC motor-driven radiator fan, and one main reservoir air cooling coil. Superstructure of locomotive. Superstructure or underframe of diesel locomotive is one of the biggest part and it is mounted on bogie or trucks. Other structure of locomotives like driver cabin, main engine, radiator, rooms and others are supported by it. The fuel tank is also attached with this superstructure. The coda life of superstructure or underframe is 36 years and it is backbone of diesel locomotive. radar. Radar is fitted in the GM locomotive and it senses the locomotive speed with respect to ground and sends the speed signal to the speedometer in the driver cabin. It is located between front bogey and fuel tank in WD G4 locomotive, and it is located in between fuel tank and rear bogey in WD P4 locomotive. Bogey. Bogey of HHP locomotive is HTSC, means high tensile steel cast. It's having two stage suspension. There are six vertical hydraulic damper and two hydraulic yaw damper in this bogey. The yaw damper are oriented in such a way that they provides damping both in lateral and yaw modes. All traction motor nose positions are oriented to the same side of each axle with the bogey frame. Other informations may be seen in this slide also. Thanks to all of you for watching and listening this video.